We're at the headquarters of one of the biggest companies in Zambia, and that is ZamBeef. To tell us a bit more about the company is Head of Marketing and Corporate Affairs, Felix Lupindula. Felix, thank you so much for chatting to us. Everywhere we go, we keep hearing about ZamBeef and how it's a wonderful success story. What is ZamBeef?
In the first place, I'd like to thank you and say that we are highly humbled by you having chosen to come and speak to us. We are a business that is involved in the production, processing, distribution and retailing of beef products, pork products and dairy products. In addition to that, we run one of the biggest row cropping operations in Zambia, producing soybeans, maize and wheat. You will notice we have a company called Novatech, which is one of the biggest stock feed companies, I think, in Zambia, maybe towards this southern region of Africa. So you can see this composite of activities, okay, it makes us an integrated business, where actually a vertically integrated business that is in the cold chain and also a production of stock feed. Yeah.
And what is the extent of your presence in the country?
ZamBeef operations are countrywide. Mm-hmm. And I would like to say that we're also in West Africa. We're in Ghana and Nigeria. Mm-hmm. Of course, in West Africa, we are there in a strategic partnership with ShopRite. We have 5 farms in Zambia. And on these farms, we have crop production and animal production. We have farms in southern province of Zambia. If you are well acquainted with the map of Zambia, central Zambia, northern Zambia, and the Copper Belt province of Zambia. So we're quite well positioned, and then our retail network is all over the country.
What are your expansion plans? Because as you said, you're already in a partnership in the West African region.
Well, in West Africa, I should say it's retail mostly, okay? Our expansion plans in Zambia, we are about to commission one of the biggest and most modern stock feed plants on the Copper Belt province of Zambia. That is Novatech plant that will be producing up to 14,000 tons of stock feed per month. I forgot to mention that we also run one of the biggest hatcheries in Zambia. Okay. It's called ZamHatch. We are going to expand and move that production from about 200,000 chicks to probably 300,000 chicks per week. That would be a big jump to satisfy our demand for broiler chicks for the local market. And why not? We could come in the near future with supplying the region, or with these poultry products. And I think as demand for food, not only in Zambia, mind you, we've been called a landlocked country for many years, which we disagree. As ZamBeef, we think we are land-linked. And our being surrounded by countries, which was seen in my primary school days as a disadvantage because we didn't have a port, is an advantage. And it's such God-given advantages, I should say, sure, that give us this ability to supply and feed the 300 million people in the Commerce and SADC region. So our expansion programs are actually demand-driven.
What impact has the recent drought had on your operation?
The impact of that is that each time there's a drought, the cost of your commodity, which is your major ingredient called maize, in your formulation of your stock feed goes high. And with that, your profitability reduces. And also, it's not only an impact on ZamBeef, it's an impact on food. As you know, maize is a staple food which the people of Zambia eat. So the impact of the drought, yes, normally causes increase of prices because supply and demand comes in.